I think it's sometimes, I think living with advanced illness often affects people's body image, self-esteem, their relationship with their body, because they sometimes feel betrayed or that they can't trust their body like they once could, or they're just really not liking what their body has put them through, pain-wise, symptom-wise, diagnosis-wise, what have you, right? And then it's sometimes hard to become trusting of that relationship again. And should you really trust your body again? And so sometimes going through a process of what is my relationship with my body? Are my mind and my body even different things? Or should I even be thinking about them as different things? Or is it better to think about them as the same, right? Sometimes people will say, I don't trust my body to keep me healthy, or I just don't believe that I won't get a recurrence. It's really hard to have those conversations, because normally when people are struggling with body image or self-esteem, often the go-to line for people is, well, just think about all the things your body can do. You know, your body is really wonderful. It's not an ornament. It's not a decoration for other people, but it's all about how your body functions day to day. So how do you say that to somebody who has advanced illness? Because maybe their body really isn't functioning very well day to day, and maybe that's the issue. It's not so much about how it looks, and sometimes it is, but sometimes it's just how it's functioning. And is your body gonna let you live? Is it gonna keep you alive for as long as you want to be alive, right? And in many cases, it's not. So then it's dealing with that tense relationship. So you don't necessarily need to come into a position where you're like totally comfortable and trusting of your body, because you've been down that road before. But it is really helpful if you can sort of find or negotiate a bit of a peace with your body so that you can live comfortably every day. And if you do get to the point of acceptance and loving it, then all the better, right? But that's not really a process that you can force very easily. And I think that also plays into this larger idea that people often feel like a different person. They don't feel like the same person that they were before they were diagnosed, right? And sometimes people like parts of their new self, and some people really long for parts of their self themselves that feel lost. And some people don't feel very changed at all, or they don't notice changes until later in their life, right? And that's a different journey for everybody.